Everybody, thanks for joining us for this quick tutorial for using Google Earth and Google Earth Projects to capture a couple of image locations that are going to be used for your TLA Energizer. We're really happy to have you here, and we'll go through these fairly quickly. So you want to go ahead and open up your browser. We prefer Chrome browser. It helps with the functionality of Google Earth. And go to earth.google.com. Your screen may open up like this, or it may open up to a specific location, but either way, you're going to launch Google Earth here. Once you've launched Google Earth, if you've launched it before, you'll see some familiar tools. In the bottom right-hand corner here, we have several tools common to all versions of Google Earth. Let's start with this compass rose. If you click on that, it will fly you to your location. We have Pegman here. Meet Pegman. He will come back to us a little bit later when we talk about photospheres and street view imagery. We have the button to toggle between 2D and 3D. We have our compass. The north arrow is the red arrow. If you ever want to reorient your view so that you have north up, you just click on that. It takes you right back to it. And of course, the plus and minus zoom buttons, which you can also zoom in and out with your trackpad or with your mouse. And then once you've zoomed in a little bit, the globe will show you where you have zoomed in, just to keep you sort of oriented there. Okay, those are the tools in the bottom right-hand corner. Let's take a look over on the left-hand side. Here we have a vertical toolbar, which takes us through the three white dashes, or what we like to call the hamburger menu. The search, of course, Voyager, which are some pre-made cards in Google Earth. I encourage you to go out and explore those. Hey, if you're feeling lucky, click I'm feeling lucky. It'll take you to some really interesting places. Google Earth Projects, this placemark, we're going to come back to that in just a moment. Down at the bottom, we have the ability to measure, but for right now, we're going to take a quick look at the map styles. You have several different map styles to choose from. I particularly like this exploration. It's an intermediate style that gives me some borders, labels, places, and roads when I'm zoomed in. You could also choose clean, especially if you're looking for lower bandwidth. You might choose clean. That gives you a little bit less detail, and if you choose everything, boy, you're going to get everything. You can also customize that look and feel. Scrolling down, you might look at turning on your 3D buildings. You can turn on animated clouds, which is also going to eat up a little bandwidth, but it's interesting to look at that, and you can turn your grid lines on and off. So those are in the map style. I want to click really quickly into the settings. So clicking on the menu and clicking on the settings gear, just so you know that this is here, you can change the speed of your animation. Some people say it makes them dizzy to fly really fast. And you can change some other things in your settings here. So I encourage you to take a look at that at some point. Okay, let's get started with Google Earth Projects. We're going to click here on the Projects button. Yours will not look like this when you open it up. I have a bunch of projects that are shown here, but let's look at the meat of this. So at the top, we see this blue New Project button. We're going to click the pull down arrow next to that. And we will notice that we can create a new project that is saved automatically right into our Google Drive. And that's what I'm going to encourage you to do here. But in the case of this assignment, you're going to be opening up a pre-created Google project. But just so you know, we can create a project right here in Google Drive. What you will be opening up from the link that we've shared with you, it's shared on the homework spreadsheet. You can access it there. Is the 2021 TLA Energizer Google Earth project. So I'm going to click that, and I'm going to open that up, and it's zooming me into someplace in Northern Africa, maybe Morocco. I'm not quite sure why, but that's okay. We can drag our map around to any position that we would like. Now you'll notice here at the top of this information card that there is an arrow pointing to the left that will take us back to a list of all of our projects. But what I want to focus on here for you are the ability to share your project just as you could share any other Google document, and also the fact that this is auto-saved. You'll notice as you're working here that everything is auto-saved directly into, yep, your drive. You got it. Okay. All right, let's jump into what you're going to actually be doing for this assignment. So you want to open up the Google Earth project that we shared with you called 2021 TLA Energizer. You can access the link for that from within the homework document. It's probably the easiest place for you to get it. And the first thing that you will notice when you arrive there is that there's a title, There's a short description, and there are already several different scenes that have been placed in there. So your assignment for this is to place two additional scenes in, one for a place that is meaningful for you, and the second for a local place in your community that's an important place. So let's go through how to do that now. The first step that you want to take is you want to zoom in to that location. So you can either use the search tool up in the top left, we showed you that before, or you can go ahead and zoom in to the specific location. I'm just going to zoom in here to the southern tip of Florida around the Everglades National Park. Once you've zoomed into that location, you're ready to set your place mark. The way you set a place mark is you come over to the blue new feature button, you click the pull down menu there, and you simply click add a place mark. Now, you'll notice that my cursor turns into a plus sign and has a box next to it that says set a location. So here you want to go ahead and find that location. You can still zoom in or zoom out. Very easy to do. And then you're going to click to drop that place mark into a location. Once you've dropped your place mark there, you notice that a dialog box opens that says save to project, gives you the ability to title the place. So I'm just going to title this place Molasses Reef. I think I'm pretty close to Molasses Reef. I want this place mark to be added to the project that's called 2021 TLA Energizer. And I could save it, at which point it would stay as it is now, but I really want to do some more work on it. So I'm going to go ahead and click Edit Place. You'll notice that once I click Edit Place, I get some new tools here. First of all, my place mark has dropped in, and I have a blue button in the bottom left of the map view that allows me to capture a view. So I can go ahead and make some changes to the view here. Perhaps I want to zoom in a little bit more. Perhaps I want to tilt my view, which I can do using my mouse by holding down the mouse button. And I'm going to click Capture This View. By capturing the view, that's what the viewer will see when they drop into this scene. Please remember that with this tool as well as others, once you've captured a view, oh, I don't like the view anymore. Maybe I'll want to zoom in a little bit more. I can recapture that view again at any time. All right. What we ask you to do for this assignment was we ask you to bring in a picture of this place. So you come up to the dialog box on the left, and you see a gray area that has a camera in it and a plus sign. You're going to click on the camera with the plus sign, and that allows you to bring in an image in a variety of different ways. So if you have that image saved on your local device, you can upload it from your local device by clicking on the select a file from your device. If you want to go out and do a Google image search right here in Google Earth Projects, you can go ahead and do a Google image search just by typing into the search box, which is what I'm going to do here. I'll type in Molasses Reef, see if anything pops up. And voila, there's a couple of places. Well, this is the spot I want here. This is called the Christ of the Abyss statue. And I was married right in front of that statue underwater. Yep. And I'm going to click on it to select it. And then I'm going to click select. Now, you'll notice here that in addition to uploading an image or doing a Google search, you could have also searched for a YouTube video. We're not doing this on this particular one. But what if you had an image saved in your Google Drive? You could click on Google Drive and navigate through your Google Drive to find that image. Perhaps your image was located in your Google Photos. You could click on your photos here, navigate into your own Google Photos and pick your image from right there. Or if your image is someplace else on the web, you can add it by URL. So once you've added your image there, you click on select, and you'll notice that your image pops up there in the area where you could add your images. Now you can also add additional images. We only ask you to add one here, but if you want to add additional, that's fine. By clicking on the camera again, you'll get the same dialog box. All right, let's move through this information card. You've got the title. Here you have a rich text enabled box where you can type in information, and you can change the look and feel of that information by making it bold, by selecting whether you want it to be a heading or title size, whatever size you want, italics. You can link to it a whole variety of ways that you can format your text there. The last thing I want to show you here is the information box itself comes up by default as being a small information box. Perhaps you want to change that to a large box. up to you. It's just a different look and feel. All right. So we have now added a scene, which is one of the assignments that you're going to do here. We've added a scene of a place that's meaningful for you with a picture and a title and a description about why that place is meaningful for you. Let's take a look at it. The preview presentation button, click it, and this is what your viewers will see when they drop into that scene. So we have the scene set on the view we captured. We've got our image in the top right, the title, and any information that we typed in there. You'll also notice that you can click on that image and it will become full screen. Very nice. For following along on that first one, of course, you're going to repeat that for your second location. Remember, for this homework assignment, for our pre-workshop webinar, as a way to introduce yourself, we're asking you to drop in two locations. Again, the first one being a place that's meaningful for you, and the second one being an important place in your local area or your local community. Okay. Last thing I want to show you today is the ability to look at a photosphere. So in Google Earth, we can use our friend Pegman here to take a look at a really immersive photosphere. And the reason I want to show you this is because we're also going to ask you to start to capture some of these photospheres using the Street View app on your cell phone. And Mark Carpenter, who you're going to meet on the next tutorial video, has captured a really great screencast for us, showing us how to capture those Street View photospheres. So let's take a look at what they look like once they're dropped into Google Earth. We're going to click on Pegman. We're going to click and hold down Pegman, and we're going to drag him out onto this map. You'll notice as soon as I clicked and dragged, a lot of things turned blue. Those are areas where there is Street View imagery. So I can bring Pegman over and I can just drop him into any one of those areas, and we will be taken right into a very immersive scene, a three-dimensional photosphere. So here we can take a look around. This looks like a pretty heavily wooded area along Gun Club Road. So we can see there, we could travel along this road. But the whole idea here is that we're feeling this immersive experience of being able to look right up at the sky or look right down at this pathway as we've been dropped in. So I want to click back out again, and I'm going to zoom out just a little bit to a different area because I would like to show you one more feature of these photospheres, if I can, and get it to cooperate. Ah, perfect. So here in this view, when I click and hold on Pegman, you'll notice that a lot of blue lines show up. That's where the Street View camera itself has been, but there are also dots. And these blue dots are individual photospheres that have been captured by people just like us. So here we zoom into this particular photosphere. In the bottom left-hand corner, we see that this was captured by somebody by the name of Ricardo Castro. And you can look around at this photosphere that was captured with this person's cell phone. So we see that it looks very much like the regular Street View imagery. We can look all the way up to see the beautiful blue sky and the sun shining there. We can look down here into the water, and we notice that there is a little bit of distortion. That's okay, that will happen sometimes when we capture our Street View images. But you'll be capturing photospheres just like this. Mark's made a tutorial video for you to follow. Okay, we're gonna click back out, and thank you for joining us on this tutorial video. We're really looking forward to meeting you all through the places that you post onto the 2021 TLA Energizer Google Earth project. We'll see you in a couple of days.